Swami ji, we also observe many people and everyone around. Many a times, you know, it is very easy to get attracted to the negatives, be it, say negative choices in food, in people, actions, addictions. So we are all at times attracted towards things that might not be good, despite knowing fully well this is not going to happen. Is it something to do with our sanskaras of the previous life? Because my karma of this life is absolutely good. I have done nothing wrong. Maybe I'm getting attracted towards something negative. So is it some kind of a sanskara, or is it hardwired neurologically that human mind and human being is first supposed to get through this as a filter before he finds light in life?
Well, the thing is this, our senses wants the pleasures. This is the thing. This is a manufacturing defect. Not our defect. This is a manufacturing defect. So the Brahma made like this. Param chikani vyatrana swayambhu. Param pashati nantaratma. Kaschid dhira pratagmanam aikshat avrit chakshu amritatvam aikshat. Says the Kathopanishad. The Brahma made this person outright, outlooking. So param chikani, all the senses, they go outside. They want to enjoy. Now, that is why we have to have self-control. So they say, Paranjikani Vyatrana Swayambhu Parang Pashati Nantaratma. It goes outside, doesn't go inside. But some few people, they meditated, they went inside. Why? For getting immortality. So it is very difficult to bring back that mind. This is a manufacturing defect. So naturally, there is no problem. Now, second thing is that, so inherently, first of all, we want sense pleasures. Now, there can be two ways of fulfilling the sense pleasure, the ethicalness and non-ethicalness. Mostly, we want shortcut. Why we are suffering? Because we want to go for shortcut. We don't want to go for labor. We don't want to pay the whole price. So, we want Apple, this mobile, in only 500 rupees. So you got a very beautiful box, packing box. You can't get the mobile. But we don't understand that and we get cheated. So, we have to pay the price. We have to labor hard. We have to prepare that. Now, what we are telling about this is samskaras does play. They do play very important part. So, samskaras. Now, a person who is able to resist the temptation, when another person is not able to resist the temptation. You know this. There is a long queue for getting the wine. You must have seen those pictures. I was so much amazed. So, such a long queue for getting the wine, and there's a small queue for getting the rice and dal and all that. What has happened? So what you tell is very right. Because of this wrong association and because of the wrong values that we have been practicing for the last few years and all that, such a degradation in the society that the people are going for such a long queue of it. So this is, of course, basically two things. It's only two things. Number one, outside environment plays a very important part. The association plays an important part. The media plays an important part. Whole day media is showing all negative things. Naturally, you become negative. And the whole society is going one direction. You become that. And third, of course, is even in this adverse circumstances, a few people are still following the values because of their samskaras. So you require extraordinary good samskaras in order to be good, excellent human being in this society. That is the paradox today. But there are some few people. Not that all have gone. But there are very few people. Now, because it is the play of samskara, that is why I told Swami Vivekananda this sentence, again very important. What we want is man-making education, character-building education. What is character? It is nothing but the bundles of samskaras. And these samskaras received from four sources. Number one, from the past births. Second, from the parents, either genetically or by behavior. Third, from the environment and from the media and all that environment. And fourth, from the education system, from the teachers. That is why teacher, I call them as torch bearers of change. In the book I have written, teacher is a torch bearer of change. I have told the noblest profession, the best profession, the highest profession, the greatest profession, that of a teacher, because it is the teachers who only can bring about the change, because they can only change the future generation. If you are a teacher in whatever capacity you are, you have a very important role to play in making India a development by 2020. Why? Because more than anybody else, it is you who are shaping the future generations. That is what Dr. Kalam has written in his book, India 2020, Vision of the New Millennium.